This is the Galactic Emperor of the Universe. I'm here to tell you all to subscribe to Unrelent Gaming and remember to turn on notifications. You will be the first to know all about the latest Dragon Ball news and information.
Oh, did you say Unrelent Gaming? Oh, I love his channel.
God damn it, Zelborn, stop rubbing your nipples and get back to bed!
The resurrected Emperor has returned to Earth as Frieza is now back, recruited by Goku for the upcoming Tournament of Power, as Goku looks to entrust Frieza with giving him a role for the team, all while the Gods of Destruction, Kitella and Seedra, gather to create a plan to destroy Frieza before the tournament begins and sending in assassins to Universe 7 in order to take care of business. What's going on, Dragon Ball fans? Welcome to my Dragon Ball Super Episode 94 review entitled The Evil Emperor Returns, a reception of mysterious assassins, leading into next week's exciting episode of Dragon Ball Super Episode 95 and what promises to be the conclusion to the backstory of Universe 7 before the actual Tournament of Power begins in July. This episode was something that I was personally waiting for, just to see everyone's reaction upon Frieza being back on Earth. But a quick plug before we begin, if you guys are new to this channel, be sure to go on ahead and punch that subscribe button for more news, information, updates, and of course discussions alongside gameplay reviews for all forms of Dragon Ball content. And make sure to also go on ahead and punch that bell icon, that way you guys are always notified whenever a Dragon Ball video is posted onto this channel, as I will be covering various Dragon Ball topics throughout the coming weeks. And of course, if you guys are not following me at Twitter, be sure to go on ahead and head over to Twitter and follow me at UnrealEndGaming to be up to date with all that is in Dragon Ball news, information, and updates. And I thank you guys for your overwhelming support on the channel, as it does go a long way. So if you guys are new, be sure to go on ahead, turn on notifications, hashtag notification squad, to be up to date with all that is in Dragon Ball. Dragon Ball Super Episode 94 is now officially in the history books, and this episode was pretty much built as the calm before the storm, as we have the assassins approach, as we had the overall ordeal occur between Frieza, Goku, and the other members. And it was an episode that I couldn't wait to see, just to see everyone else's reaction upon seeing Frieza back on Earth ever since debuting, coming back in ROF. But either way, guys, we start the episode off exactly where we left off, with Goku and the gang at Capsule Corp pretty much eating some food in preparation before the tournament. And you can clearly tell, based on Vegeta's demeanor, that he is not happy about Frieza being back. So this episode, pretty much in the beginning, it recaps how Goku pretty much told everyone that he did in fact promise Frieza that he was gonna bring him back to life if in fact they win. And what's funny about this is we see Krillin spill his drink and Vegeta smacks the table. He's like, what? And Goku ensures that Frieza is not going to betray anybody. And again, once the official subs on Crunchyroll drop, I'm gonna go on ahead and talk more of that, as a lot of the translators were not available as of today. But either way, as Goku is explaining the situation to Krillin and Vegeta, we see how Kitara is making a deal with Seedra. Now, the one thing about Kitara that I'm not really understanding here is the fact that his universe is quite unknown when it comes to fighters, and Seedra doesn't really have anybody on his team aside from Basil, Lavenda, and of course Bergamo. And with that being said, it's like, why is Seedra so worried about Frieza when he should be gathering up team members for his own respective team? It doesn't make any sense. But either way, what I really liked about this episode was how little Trunks pretty much walked over. He saw a picture of Frieza, in which it had been done on like Photoshop, it had been done on like Paint. It was so goofy looking, and Trunks walks on over and he asks who that is. And of course, you know, Goku trying to tell Bulma not to reveal who Frieza is, and Vegeta walks on over and he pretty much, you know, tries to lie to Trunks. So Trunks is very curious as a kid, because keep in mind, when Frieza came to Earth originally back with his father King Cold during the Android Saga, we see how Trunks was still a baby. So Trunks has no recollection as to who this is, because little Trunks had never met Frieza before. Which again, you have to look at this episode from a standpoint to where Frieza is now coming back to Earth, and everyone has a problem with that considering what happened last time in Frieza blowing up the entire planet. So everyone's looking at Goku here as if like he's like the enemy, but again, there is no choice here. The only candidates that we have are Majin Buu, who's asleep, Yamcha, and Frieza. And of course, do you really want to replace, you know, Majin Buu with Yamcha or Frieza on this one? So either way, everyone's talking. The dashboard is there. We have everyone's picture, and we see how Goku approaches Krillin, and he talks to Krillin about how Frieza is going to be coming there any moment now. And of course, which does happen, because Baba ultimately enough brings Frieza to Earth. But even with that being said, there is a level of concern here, because we don't know in which direction, based especially on the Dragon Ball Super spoilers, as to what's going to happen next. We understand that episode 95 and 96 are going to have huge correlations in tying in together and revealing more information information on whether or not Frieza does betray Universe 7, but we see Krillin thinking about his family. Everyone is pretty much, you know, like, just holding on to, like, dear preciousness here, because this is literally the moment before we go out to the world of Void. And with that being said, we see Master Roshi, and if you guys want my thoughts on Roshi, it was just kind of, like, unneeded to see what he does now, because after this entire time of Roshi pretty much chasing Pawar and doing all these things and not benefiting the team, even though he was secretly training, what I enjoyed about this, at least, was the fact that we saw him pick up, you know, Yajirobe up, and he, you know, we understand we can't use the Mafuba, because the Mafuba is actually, you know, a containment jar that's going to be used, and that's actually considered to be an item. So technically speaking, the Mafuba jar is considered an item, a foreign weapon, so you can't really use that. So we see how Master Roshi drops Yajirobe on his head, and, you know, they begin to talk, and what's cool about this is they're actually doing this over on Korin's tower. So with that, we pan over to Sidra's universe, and he has a conversation with Ro, the Kaioshin, and Ro is the one that pretty much suggests that, you know, they need to, because he explains everything about Frieza, and Ro is really upset on the idea that a dead fighter is going to be participating in the tournament. Again, you have to look at, you know, where Ro is coming from, because they understand how strong Goku is, and now they come to the realization that someone else just as strong, or if not just a little bit under Goku, is going to be there too as well. That's going to pose a really credible threat to all the other imposing universes. So what does Ro want to do? The assassins are going to be making their way towards universe number 7. If I was Ro and or Sidra, I would worry more about my own fighters than anything else. But we get to see how Goku travels out with Baba to go pick up Frieza, and we see up in the sky there are these warriors, these assassins, and they're all above the sky. And then we cut to Android 18 and Android 17, which I really, that's, if anything, I really enjoy that about this episode, because Krillin now, who is the brother-in-law, is meeting 17. Trunks and Goten are out, because remember, Trunks and Goten are in charge of watching over the forest that 17 guards over. So we see how 17 is talking to his sister, and Krillin is being a little awkward because, yeah, he's married to his sister and whatnot, so that's always going to be a little weird. And we see how 17 finally meets Krillin and Android 18's child, which is a pretty cool moment, because I don't think that their daughter has ever met 17 before, and 17 looks to be, you know, so compassionate, especially even one scene where the water splashes on the side of the mountain, and 17 is very aware of this. So I would have to say that 17 and 18 are very, very, very aware of their environment, because judging based on going into this tournament, yeah, they're artificial humans, but just keep in mind, they're going to be fighting against Moscow's fighters as well, who are cyborgs and machines and stuff, so I cannot wait to see that. But of course, Trunks, Goten, and of course 18 and Krillin's daughter are left behind to watch over the island. And then we go and we see like these poachers, right? They have like this submarine in the water. So you already know, like, during the Tournament of Power, while they're all fighting like in the World of Void, Trunks and Goten are going to have a hard time, or at least a difficult time, having to encounter these people, these poachers, who want to destroy the entire island. So you don't want to put, you know, their daughter at risk here. But we see how 17, Krillin, and 18 take off as they head back to Capsule Corp. And finally, 17 arrives. And it's just a very awesome moment to see 17 meeting everyone once again. Shin is there. Shin is observing everything. So it's a really cool moment, because now it's the official gathering. Piccolo is there. Vegeta is there. The androids are there. You know, Master Roshi arrives, so everyone is finally getting together, and at long last, Piccolo and 17 have a conversation, which again, if you guys remember, those two had a very intense fight. So this is like the first time they're meeting each other ever since that moment, and that was a feeling that I got of nostalgia because of how awesome that moment was back in Dragon Ball Z. So as everyone is finally gathering together, you know, everyone seems to be like, you know, kind of like tense during the whole idea of like just having to compete during this. So, you know, Goku patiently awaits for Baba to bring back Frieza. So he's pretty much like, you know, sparring himself. He's like jumping around, you know, practicing his moves or whatever. And then finally, Goku stops. He looks over by the door and he heads towards the door. So he senses something. He feels something there. It's a very ominous moment because we see candles there and the candles are all lit. There's like a skull on the wall. It's some pretty like, you know, satanic shit. But finally, at long last, Frieza's spirit manifests and we see Frieza re-enter the real world as Frieza stands before Goku. It was a very awesome moment to see, because now we see him with the halo and he looks up and he sees the halo and he seems a little bummed now, but he's actually happy that he's back. So personally for me, guys, as a fan, I am happy to see Frieza and Goku literally at the same place at the same time. And Frieza punches Goku right in the stomach, kind of saying, I'm glad to be back. And we see how Goku's trying to catch his breath. And then he punches Frieza and saying, yeah, I'm glad you're on the team as well. So it was such a cool moment, because as Frieza punched Goku, it was one of like those dick moves, like, hey, I hate you, but it is what it is. And we see how they're about to take off, and then all of a sudden, there's like an army of assassins just waiting for them to come out. And Goku leaves, he looks up in the sky, and you know, the leader, I suppose, of like these assassins is like this dog. Don't take these people serious, guys. I mean, the only thing they have on Goku and Frieza are numbers. But either way, all of a sudden, this beam just comes out of nowhere, and Frieza shoots down the dog that's talking to Goku. He shoots him right on the spot, and I love that. I love that so much, because as soon as he comes back, he starts murking people with, like, his death beam. So he death beams him in the shoulder, the guy goes down, and everyone else, you know, pretty much refocuses their attention on Frieza, because right before, you know, Frieza even attacked, Goku's trying to speak to them, and out of nowhere, we see how Frieza arrives, and he shoots the guy down. So Beerus actually is sleeping on the chair, and all of a sudden, he wakes up, because he has, like, this feeling, you know, something's going on. So, you know, in conclusion, the episode, I think, was a very, very calm and mellow episode, pretty much, you know, showcasing the tension between all the fighters, between all of the members having to, you know, understand the idea that Frieza's here, and the armies above, you know, Goku and Vegeta having to make their point across and saying, we're gonna take you guys down. And we see how Goku's trying to use instant transmission. He's trying to get away from there, and he tells Frieza, you know, grab my hand, you have to come with me. And Frieza being Frieza, he kind of like refuses at first, but Goku's telling him, like, listen, you need to come with me. And we see how irritated he is. And of course, right towards the very end, Goku's trying to persuade Frieza in not doing anything crazy, in which that's what Frieza wants to do, because by the end of it, we see how Frieza taps into his golden power. And it was a moment to where you had to think on your feet. It's like, what do you do? Do you encounter the assassins? Are you gonna fight them off? Like, are you gonna flee the scene? Because these assassins aren't anything to take serious, because again, if Goku didn't take him serious, it's like, why should Frieza? But Frieza being trapped in hell for so long, he just had that need to do so. So again, seeing as how this episode is building up to Frieza and Goku having to fight the assassins towards the very end, we see how Frieza is in his golden form, and he looks amazing. And finally, aside from that, we see the tournament come together, which I thought the tournament was already established. Like, what was that about? Like, that was really dumb. But either way, Frieza taps into his golden form, and Goku is observing him, and Frieza has no remorse in trying to bully his way through, in trying to showcase his dominance towards these individuals, because that's the ultimate plan. He wants to toss his weight around. Of course, Dragon Ball Super episode 95 spoilers reveal that, but I would like to hear what you guys think down in the comment section below. What did you guys think about this episode? What did you guys think about Frieza having to be back? What are your overall thoughts on Frieza's interaction alongside everybody else? And do you guys think that Frieza does have a plan conjured up in his head in order to get back at Goku? Because something gives off that vibe that Frieza may actually have a plan set in stone. But I want to hear your thoughts down below as to how powerful you guys think Frieza is now in comparison to ROF, if there's any significant changes. Thank you all for watching. Once again, if you guys are new to the channel, be sure to go on ahead and punch that subscribe button to keep up to date with all the latest Dragon Ball news, information, updates, and of course, discussions. If you guys enjoyed the review, don't forget to go on ahead and leave a like down below if you guys are ready for next week's episode. Tune back in for more. Finally, the Tournament of Power is going to begin in July, and I cannot wait, because literally ever since January/December, when they first announced this arc, we were all speculating as to what's going to happen, when it's going to begin. And now, fast forward a couple of months later, and now we have the official opening taking place in July. So what are your overall expectations for that? Thank you all for watching, guys. As always, tune back in for more, and I'll be seeing you all down in the comment section below. Have a great night, guys. Peace.